Certain skills seem so basic that they don't really seem worth discussing, but it turns out that knowing some of the special tricks can make your life a lot easier. This applies to Google Sheets as it applies to so many other things. And what I want to show you in terms of basic skills is simply how to select data and move it around. Now, obviously, if you want to select just one cell, you get your cursor and you click on that cell and you can move it around by doing the arrows. Here I am driving it around with the arrows. That's selecting one cell. That's easy. If you want to select a column, just come and click on the letter above that column and you've got the entire thing. If you want to select more than one column, click and drag across. Now you've got columns. And the same thing works for rows. Just click on the row number and you select the entire row. You can select several rows as well by clicking and dragging. So that's easy. If you want to select the entire spreadsheet, come up here and click on this area that's to the top left. And that selects everything, every single cell in the entire spreadsheet. Let's come back up to here. Let's say I want to select just this first row. Now, actually, to make this easier, I'm going to maximize my screen so you can see the entire data set. I'm first going to go full screen on my Mac, and then I'm going to hide these controls right here. And so now you can see I've got a data set with an empty column right here, and I've got an empty row right here. That's going to affect how some of this stuff works. Now, let me come up to here. I'll just stick the cursor right here. If I want to select an entire column, I can do it with the keyboard by doing Control and Space. And you see what it does is it selects vertically until it thinks it has reached the end of the data. And it thinks it's reached the end because I've got this big empty row right here, so it ignores it. On the other hand, if that row were not empty, let's say I put an X there, and I were to give this a title up here, I'll call that X also. Now it's going to unite the whole data set. I'm going to come back over to here. I'll hit Control and Space. And now you see it selects down to the bottom because now it sees this all as one unified whole, even though there are gaps in it. So Control Space selects the entire current column. I'll do Control Space right here. And if I want to expand my selection, I can do Shift and then use an arrow, right arrow or left arrow, to get more of what I want. There's a similar command for selecting rows. So let me just hit Escape. I'll just click right here. And I'll do Shift Space. And what this does is it selects the entire row in the data rectangle. And if I want to expand that, I can use the down arrow or I can use the up arrow. And that is a way of selecting data, sometimes a little more precisely than dragging through with the cursor. One other thing that you want to know is about moving data. So say, for instance, I want to move this score so it's on the other side of category. What I do is you see how I selected it? Now when I come up here, I have a hand. If I just click and drag over, I've switched them around. I'll put it back by undoing that move. That's really easy. I do the same thing right here. I'll expand that. I can click and just drag down my data and move it to a new position. And this can be an important way of fixing the way that you've entered things. You can sort things manually with an ID number, but in terms of rearranging variables, the click and drag is by far the easiest way to go. And so the ability to click on individual cells and then expand by doing Shift and the arrows, or to select rows and columns within the data rectangle by doing Control and Space or Shift and Space, are great ways to grab the data you need and perform the functions you want. It's a small thing, and again, doesn't always seem worth it mentioning, but it can make your life much quicker and less error prone when working in Google Sheets.